Hi cuties, Sharkutie here, and today we're going to be talking about one of my dream cosplays. Obviously, as you read from the title, it is Cure White from Futari or Precure Max Heart. I contemplated about it a lot between Max Heart and Futari, or the original version. I decided to go with Max Heart because it is the version you see in every single All-Stars movie or like crossover movie, however you want to put it. But yeah, so it took me about 10 years to finally do this cosplay. I mean, I encountered Precure when I was about 9 or 10 maybe, and it was from the YTV dub, and I still love that dub. I really wish that they continued forward because Canada really does really good dubs, hence why Bakugan's one of my favorite animes. So yeah, so today we're going to be talking about just how I made the cosplay and what happened when I did it and how I just went through it, because I didn't film while making it because I think that I wanted to figure out how to make it first and how to make it look right the way I wanted it before I actually wore it to a con or made it myself, because it took me about 6 months to make this and actually about a month of working on it consistently if I was to spend the time for it, because I always thought about doing this cosplay but I never actually did it because I didn't think about doing Precure until I was like, it's been way too long since I've done magical girls or doing a magical girl to begin with. So I mean, as you can see, I love Precure, and it's only lately that I've been collecting the cutie figures, and my favorite figures are the Cuposkets, let me just say that. So I don't have the Futari Max Heart one yet, but White is my best girl, so I will be getting that soon, hopefully. So yeah, it's only like this big, so I wanted the bigger one because they look like dolls and I love them. But yeah, regardless, we're gonna be talking about this cosplay today. Yeah, so let's start with the wig. This wig was, it's from a Halloween costume. It is the Zen and Stew Eevee wig. I only decided to go with this wig because I did buy it for Yusaku, but I love the thing with Ruby. It's a Ruby's wig, so I was really, like, it is a higher brand of costuming, but I love the color, is what it came down to. For White's color, it's kind of hard because it is a black, it is a blue, and I've seen people use the bright blue from the black, and I wanted something in between. So I could have used, Umi's wig, so from Love Live, like, I could have used one of those wigs. However, I think that I wanted to use something more voluminous and more, not shiny, but like, if you can see with my wig, it kind of just, it blooms, like it has volume, although it is shorter, like her hair goes down to here or something. The only reason I didn't do that because even with a heavier wig or longer wig, you wouldn't get that volume, like as like voluminous as you wanted to, and that just causes headache. So I'm really happy with like the shorter wig and the volume that it has by itself. If you can, her little cutie figure herself, her hair goes down to about here. So I am not that far off, but it is a lot shorter. But I mean, Evie's wig is, or hair is, okay. Anyways, Evie's wig should be like a little bit longer regardless. However, they've made it shorter, which I think is more manageable on the other hand. So I'm really, like, I like how it looks. And it is proportional, so it looks right, even though it is just shorter in the back, but I think that's fine. So we're gonna start with the construction of, like, I guess we could start with the dress, which is probably the thing that you saw most progress of on my Instagram. I still have extra threads around, but it is right here. It's been in frame because it's like poofy as ever. So let's turn the camera. All right, so you can see the skirt of the dress. I started as a circle skirt, so hence this blue layer is one circle skirt, and then it's scalloped at the bottom. I was originally going to do the Phoenix version, but I ended up doing the Max Heart version, so it has enough scallops for the Phoenix version. So I don't know how many scallops the Max Heart version has, but I think it's kind of relatively similar, so that's why I kept it going on with it. And you can't really tell, and I think that many of the Cure White cosplayers out there either haven't been paying attention to the scallops, or they've just been making a straight out circle skirt and then adding this on. The thing with white, every single rendering image and concept image, the pleating is slightly, or not the pleating, the scalloping is slightly different. It's also the fact that the color of the outline on the scalloping is different, and it's been, for me, I look at color so much that this was a darker blue to me before I put on the white, and it was different with this blue on top. So for me, that colors are really, like, I have to overlay them with the other colors to see if that's the right color. But even if you look at the figure to this, the figure is greener, but like, it's whiter, I don't know. Every single concept art has been different, and the most recent one for the crossover movie with Hugtail Precure was a gradient. So it was very, very difficult to decide what color to do, but I ended up going with this one, and I think I really liked how it looks. It was actually for Asuka, which is what I bought this for, and then I went to Hime, and, or not Hime, Cure Princess, and now I have to buy a new fabric for Cure Princess because I used most of it on Cure White. But regardless, yeah, so essentially for this I did use a pattern for the top, which I will get to, but the bottom wasn't a pattern. I did it from my measurement of the waist and the circle calculator, which you can find online. The layer on top is a shorter circle skirt, but then I cut from it to make the scallops. And okay, I'm gonna take it down. This thing, it varies on each concept art as well, by the way. So I thought I could see that there was one scallop, two, and then the three, and the smaller one in the middle. However, you can't see that on every art, and it's very hard. Yeah, so you can see that it is sewn here and here, just together. And yeah, the scalloping matches on the top and bottom. So what I did with that outline for the scalloping was, let me put it back, was I did a pattern for it. So I drew whatever the bottom, and then I put it on the fabric, cut it, added its seam allowance, and then first of all I did it a couple ways. So first of all I did it with like the length of the fabric, and so there was like three loops on one thing, and then I connect, put it on the fabric to measure out on here, and it wouldn't curve as much as I wanted it to, so hence why I did every individual scallop. So there is a seam right here connecting them together, right here. So some of them obviously aren't perfect, but hence because I am still working on my sewing skills. But overall, this is one of my best cosplays, and I really am happy with it. Oh, I hate when there's threads everywhere. Is this a thread or is this hot glue? It's a thread. Okay, I have to cut some off. Anyways, it's really hard to miss. It's really easy to miss is what I'm trying to say. And then, so essentially, I sat and thought about this for like a couple hours, and it kept me awake at night because I had to figure out a way to do this cleanly, because I looked at everyone's cosplays online and everything was just, it was either that they like shorthanded it and made it this whole strip. And I know that there's this cosplayer, I think her name's Regina. She did it like, it wouldn't work with my cosplay because I have the poof underneath. But hers was looping underneath and over and underneath because she sewed on, ribbon or something, a strip. And it caused it to, like, do the waving for her. But with my cosplay, I wanted it flat on the dress. So I couldn't follow that or, yeah. So what I did was I ended up, like, making the little loop or the line of scallops. And then I stitched the bottom, like I stitched right good side to wrong side, and then I flipped it up and then stitched it down on the top. So some places there are a little bit of error, but I either just I missed it, so I either glued it down or like stitched it in. Yeah, because it was really hard to make it a constant strip, like, and fold it down. So like, I'm happy how it looks, but I wish I had more, yeah, of time with the skirt thing to make it look cleaner, but it is clean and I like how it looks. And like, I wanted to use white, like white threads running through the whole thing. So that's what I kept with. All right. So for the top, I used a pattern. You can see here that it has a dart here, a dart here. And it was a short sleeve pattern, so I have the sleeves here. And then the back is here, here. I think I had to add to it. So I believe this is the pattern I did use for the Rapunzel dress I made last year for my friend, which was never complete because I still have to pin it to her. But I highly doubt she's gonna wear it again. She's not a cosplayer. I don't know, like, I'm fine making commissions for people. I just didn't understand why. She was like, sure, I'll join. But then she doesn't like pictures, but she wanted to experience cosplay with me. So I was like, okay, sure. Okay, regardless. So it's a basic dress pattern. So essentially, without all the ruffles and the bows, it would have been perfectly fine as like a white top dress and a skirt. So that's what it was looking like before. With the same pattern, it had a nice look of sleeves as well. So I took the sleeve pattern and had, so it was actually kind of like a bell dress. It went here and here for the sleeves. So I removed this part and then I just followed everything there to make the oversized sleeves. I think I did a tiny bit of adding on to it to make it cup over. Otherwise, I followed that pattern pretty closely and then I added the ruffles on at the end. So with the ruffles, obviously I sewed them first. Well, I pinned them, I sewed them to have the ruffles in, and then I sewed them to the dress. And then the bow, obviously I did a simple bow pattern and then put it together. And I highly recommend you sew your bows. I mean, you can hot glue them, but I hate hot glue. Like, it's helpful and useful, like say for like my hearts here. Like, so I took a foam heart and hot glued the fabric to it. The only downside to using hot glue is the fact that it comes brittle and it varies depending on temperature outside. So if it's hot, it will melt off. If it's too cold, it'll become brittle and zip. So you've got to be careful with that. So that's why I always recommend you sew and maybe use tacky glue. But be careful with tacky glue because it does come off in the machine, in the washing machine. So hence, especially with my cosplays, most of them are okay to put in the washing machine. Anything with glue on it, I don't recommend you putting it. I don't put my cosplays in them. But like this one, I could obviously put in. The heart is safety pinned in, so I can remove it and wash it. So, yeah. So, obviously, we're missing a part that is the ruffles and. Okay. Obviously, we're missing the part that is the ruffles. So, White has a line of ruffles under her skirt. I debated how to do that as well. And yes, I could have done and made it part of the dress and have it, like, come out from under the. Like, have it a layer in here. I decided not to do that. Purposely because it would have been too thick to probably fold properly and you'd have to iron it out. And when you do that sort of thing with a curve, it doesn't always work out for you. So, my solution to that was a separate skirt, which I could probably use in other cosplays. I was technically supposed to make one for Blue Angel, but I never got to it. So that's why you can see my underskirt line things in my pictures with pointers. Or Ponder, whatever you want to call him. Anyways, so I made the skirt. So I took a piece of lining. It's essentially just a normal skirt. And then I gathered it to make the thing. I think it's called an eyelet fabric. I don't remember. My mom said what it was and then I didn't pay attention. Because I'm like, it's a skirt. And I'm like, yeah. So this goes underneath and then the skirt goes on top. So essentially you could wear the dress like that. But obviously I'm extra and it goes on with the poof. So I'll get to the poof after. But this is the skirt that goes underneath here and gives it the complete look of white. Let's talk about accessories. So here are my gloves. Obviously I didn't talk about lining, but it probably should be lined. I mean, White doesn't have that many issues with lining because of the way I've done it, but the top part I didn't line and I probably should and I regret it now. I hate lining. Like, I put facings in, but I hate lining. Even when I make commissions, I kind of debate about making lining and yarn, but I do the lining first so then I don't have to think about it. So yeah, and then I make the dress after, so then I've done it already. But with this, I did line it because this is the fabric I used for the darker blue. It's a velvet, so it was shedding, so I had to line it so it wouldn't gum. But yeah, so essentially these are the gloves that I made. They're a little bit short, but I think with my proportions, they look better with the shorter one. So I did the foam parts again. These ones are hot glued on. I have to add a pin to it so they don't fall off. And yeah, I did the ruffling in the same way. I have a zipper on it so they would match. I wanted the fabric to match. And then there is a snap button at the top. So essentially, I hope this is the one that I can put on by myself. If not, then I have issues. It is the one I can't put on by myself. So, okay. So essentially how you put them on would be to zip them up here. Sorry, like I have so much issues with this. I had to figure out the pattern, I had to figure out everything. Because this was like, first I measured around my hand and then cut it, but it's not a stretch fabric, so it won't actually do what you think it will do. So yeah, so there, I zipped it part way and then done it. Obviously there's some errors and some, but it is cleaner than, like, it is like, I feel like I should remake them now that I know how to make them, but I don't know. And essentially you can add the loop at the top, so it goes around like a fingerless glove, but I think I was okay without it. Okay. Snap. So yeah, they look like this on me, and I wanted it to gather at the wrist as they do in the show, so yeah. Oh, this is strange. I think I did this on the wrong hand. After that struggle, it's on the wrong hand. Because one hand of mine is obviously smaller than the other because human anatomy, but yeah. And then the other one, yeah, it is, because I just like this, my hands, yeah. So see, they look like this at the end, and I'm actually really happy how it turned out. Yeah, so And then obviously I did I don't know what to call these, boot covers, leg warmers, whatever you want to call these. Johan has them too. He's not a pretty girl, but actually he's a princess. He's a Disney princess. Anyways, I do have to do some more stitches with these, I believe. Or no, I don't. No, I don't. They're good. So essentially I did do just two strips of fabric that fit, and then trim the bottom, add the ribbon, and then added the ribbon. Trim the ruffles, then added the ribbon, and the ribbon does it's the heat and bond, and then I did the safety pinned heart. So the safety pin goes through the fabric, that's why it doesn't fall off. And then the fabric's gathered at the back with hot glue, which you could probably do with ribbon, with hand stitching. The reason I use hot glue is because then it sticks to the front, but you have to be careful and use really hot glue, so yeah. And then obviously these were sewn on, and then top stitched on top. And the scalloping, I hate scalloping. And I've done scalloping for two cosplays now, and I want a cosplay cure star, which has petals as star, yeah. Or even cure Celine, her inverted scallops. Oh my god. So yeah, so these have my attempt at what scallops are and or how to make scallops, but yeah. Oh god, this is a long video. So yeah. And then, alright, and then the pouch, obviously, is the last thing. So I made this by hand, and then I glittered, papered on things, and made the bow, and foam heart, did the heart. I tried painting it, didn't work, so that's why I did this. And there's a snap holding it together. Obviously, I could have got the real one, because I own the real card commu, our heartful commu, and have the actual cards in here. This is the Korean version of the Heartful Commu, by the way. So, and it does fit in the pouch, so the cards. So then it just snaps down and it does hold it. So this is made out of air dry clay, painted and then sealed, and this is the same fabric over. I haven't switched the color machine, that's why it's not together yet. But then, yeah, it's held together with a button and elastic. The reason I did that, I like buttons because they hold, and then the strap, you know, is elastic, so then it stretches, it pulls, but it stays on. I like those much better than Velcro and things. Velcro I don't like because it can destroy half your cosplay, and or it can fall off. I have that done with Judai, and I have to fix Judai. All right, so I have three petticoats, so one tutu and two actual petticoats that I made. I guess to call them petticoats, but they're kind of not because they're made of, what is it called? I forget what they're called, but I use them all out of the time. So my first underlayer is this tutu, which I've had from dance. I don't even remember what, oh, it's from my Muppets dance costume. Essentially, it was like a really cute, and then it had like a half tuxedo thing in sequins. But yeah, I use this underneath now. And then I put this layer on top. So you can see that it's been worn, I have to fix it, but I haven't fixed it. This is the stuff I'm talking about. There's two layers of it on. You find it at Holidays, and they sell them at Lens Mills now, and yeah. So it doesn't add a natural poof, and there's two layers of that on it, and then it's over a skirt. The skirt's pink because it's from my Yuki cosplay, where her innards were pink, so I had to compensate for that like this. And then there's this giant one. So there is two layers, or three, is it two? There's two layers, but there's three other. Like, there's a base dress and then layers on top of it. This one has a lot more gathering, so therefore it is thicker, it poofs more. This one I wear under, both of these I wear under Blue Angel. All these I wear under Blue Angel, actually. Her poofiness is the same as Cure White's. But this one I wear under one specific cosplay and by itself, and I don't remember what it is. But yeah. So basically it's just a giant floofy thing. And yeah, and this is how I stuffed my macaron skirt as well last year. And yeah, so that was the wig head. Anyways, that's basically it for my cosplay. Like, I wanted to do more of these talking videos with my cosplay because I'm working so hard on these now that I need to actually show what I'm doing. And the fact that I don't like showing them while I make them. So me doing it after and telling you what I've done to make them is a lot more fun, I guess. Currently I'm finishing up Mako from Digimon for the kitchen cart things. So it's Mako in a sweater dress of Makumon. So I'm just about done that. I have to finish the tails. And these things are like projects for me, like art projects. So I have to figure out everything. And so yeah, so I'll finish Makumon and do another video like this on it. And obviously it's not for me, so that won't be until after.